Now to developing Ebola crisis, the Obama administration is urging people not to panic over the single case of Ebola here in the United States. The announcement came today during an unusual high-level briefing at the White House to reassure the public that a widespread outbreak here is unlikely. Now, this man, Thomas Duncan, was diagnosed in Dallas early this week after contracting the virus in Liberia. The apartment where he lived is now being wrapped in plastic and decontaminated. Dozens of people he had contact with are being monitored. Four of them are in quarantine.
With so many cases of Ebola in West Africa, though, how can airports prevent infected people from hopping on a plane?
At this airport in Liberia, people first have to answer a questionnaire and then go through several checkpoints, which include being tested for fever. But there's still a real possibility someone with the virus could come through the Minneapolis-St. Paul International Airport. And our Joe Augustine is there live tonight. And Joe, you've learned that there are some precautionary measures that are in place right here at home.
Yeah, that's right, Tom. Now, you really won't notice a lot of those precautionary measures that are being taken unless you're showing symptoms. And really, you got to think about it. The chances of you crossing paths with somebody who has contracted the Ebola virus while you're traveling, very slim. But based on that slim chance, they have set up a quarantine area here in the international arrival section just in case someone does show symptoms. You have to remember, too, a lot of people traveling to and from Africa will step foot in this airport because so many people in the Twin Cities area are from Africa. Now, if someone gets here and starts feeling a fever or some of the other symptoms, they will be held in that quarantine area until they can be taken to a hospital. The emergency preparedness director at the Hennepin County Medical Center told us today they have responded to this airport once before.
The person was identified at the airport as having a fever, brought here for evaluation, and turned out to have malaria.
Now, that doctor told us that they were initially fairly concerned with that person as well as one other person, but after a quick evaluation, they were able to quickly determine that they did not have Ebola and they were released from that quarantine area that they have at the medical center.
Okay, so at the airport there, who's in charge of the quarantine area?
Well, Tom, really, the airport has nothing to do with the quarantine area other than that it's set up here. The CDC is in charge of that. And really, I'm told it's actually a very small area because it's not meant for long-term evaluation or treatment. It's just meant to hold people until they can be taken to the hospital for that evaluation or treatment.
All right, Joe Augustine, live at MSP tonight.